Let us talk about some ways that women manipulate you as men, some powerful techniques that women use to control you, to manipulate you, to make you do their bidding, to control you in particular. Okay, some of you do not see this because of too much love blindness. Okay, some of you do not see, but if you let it linger, on the long run, you're going to be unhappy in your relationship or in your marriage. So if you see this initially, you can call her out on this bullshit and just try to tell her that no, you're not going to do this to me. And sometimes women do this without knowing that it's manipulation. They just see it like woman power. But if we are being honest, it's actually manipulation, and no woman should be treating a man who loves her this way. So let me tell you some of these tricks and tactics they use to try to control you as a man. So hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl IJ. This is Real Talk with IJ. You know how we do it here, so make sure you stay subscribed. And if you're first time here, it's okay, relax, watch this video until the end. If it's what you like and if you enjoyed it, please make sure you subscribe, like, and share so that other people can find my channel. Okay, so let us quickly go into this dirty games that women play. All right, now the very first I'm going to talk about is love bombing. And really, love bombing is a thing that I'm beginning to see now on social media with a lot of, couple channel. Let me put it that way. Now, most times women will come into your life and they will become your sunshine. They will give you so much love, so much attention. They will be the woman of your dream. They will give you sex morning, afternoon, night. They will cook, they will clean, they will be submissive, they will do everything in that 1 month of just meeting them. You'll be like, where have you been all my life? And you're thinking, God, I just hit the lottery. I just, hit the jackpot. This is the woman of my dream. Okay, see that initial thing they're doing is love bombing. A lot of them cannot keep up with it. A lot of them are not real. Once they have pumped you with so much love that you've never seen in your life, you're now trapped in that web of love. And then they start pulling away. Now, when they start pulling away, you start pursuing them for that love. You start like, where's the woman I once met? Where's the person that I used to love? Now you're thinking to yourself, maybe I've done something wrong because she's not giving me attention like that anymore. She's not giving me so much sex anymore. I mean, I think something is wrong. Maybe it's me. And you find yourself, apologizing always for something that you did not even do. It's called love bombing. Love doesn't just happen. Trust me, if you meet someone, you need time to get to know them. You need time to actually fall in love with them. That's the honest truth. That's what I believe. I don't, maybe let me know in the comment section what you think, but I feel like if you meet someone, you need time to fall in love with them. You can't just meet them on Monday and on Sunday, you're already sewing matching attires, wanting to come for family cookout, wanting to help his mom to prepare Sunday dinner. Be careful, okay? This is how they find their way into your life. They use so much love to trap you, and then they start pulling away, and now you start begging so much to get just a fracture, I'd be a fraction of what they used to give to you. Okay, so love bombing is one way women manipulate you and keep you under their control, because now you're following them up and down, just begging for that attention that they poured on you, the initial time you just started dating them. Another bad way women try to control you, and this one, I hate this one with passion, is the comparison. I hate when people compare. Just naturally, even as a girl, I hate comparison. Like, even while I was a child, if my mom tried to tell me, oh, your sister this, you don't do, I get so pissed. I hate comparison. And if you're in a relationship where a girl is constantly comparing you, whether to her ex, to her brothers, to her friends, to people, other people's relationship, don't take it. It's very, very disrespectful. Now, it's okay for a woman to want to try to make you better. I mean, you can't lie to yourself, okay? So if you know that you're actually a bad person, you're smoking, you're drinking, you're womanizing, you're cheating and doing all sorts of bad things, you're stealing and killing, and your woman is trying to tell you, why can't you be like this person who is upright, at least the positive side, okay? Fine, it's kind of understandable. But if she never says, oh, you are an amazing person, she only criticizes and compares you all the time. She's always just comparing you, always making you feel small, making you feel like you're not good enough because you're not a certain person. Let them go date that certain person. Honestly, they should go date their father. They should go date their brothers. If they're always comparing you with their siblings, they should go date that sibling or go date that ex. Or like, why did the ex leave if you were so great? Like, why do you have to constantly compare me to him? Like, oh, my ex did. No. Okay, never take comparison. Okay, comparison makes you feel small as a man. They're trying to make you feel small so that you do everything they say because you want to be better than whoever they are comparing you with. You want to, prove a point to her. So just do not take comparison because it can really get too extreme. Like I said, there are some times that they're comparing you just to make you feel better, but then it can get so extreme that they are trying to control you, make you into somebody that you are not, someone that they can have complete power over. Okay, so comparison is a means women use to manipulate men, and I don't want you to keep falling for that trap. Thirdly, is going to be always playing the ex card. Like when a woman, this one is even very crazy. It's as crazy as, the comparison. When a woman keeps bringing up her ex in every discussion, every disagreement, oh, my ex will never do this to me. Oh, my ex got me this on my birthday. Oh, my ex would have done this. Maybe there's an issue and there's a certain way you handle it. She'll be like, you know what? My ex would have done better. My ex would have fought this guy. My ex would have, That's too much disrespect, and you should never tolerate it. My ex will make me come more. My ex was better in bed. But if the ex was so good, why are you not with him? You get my point. Stop swallowing it. Okay, my ex was making a certain amount of money. My ex was this. Don't fall for it. Okay, do not. You are the man in the picture now. So she should take. She saw all of this and decided to spend life with you or do life with you. So do not allow women manipulate you into becoming that ex. If he was so great, she would have stayed with him. So if she's always coming up with the ex card, it's just very disrespectful, and it's just her trying to control you or blackmail you into doing something that you initially didn't want to do. So do not tolerate that. Number four is women playing dumb. And you know what? I saw this recently on Instagram in Nigeria, where a man, and this is actually very bad, okay? If you're a woman and you do this, it's very terrible. I don't care what you have to say. Where a man confronted his pregnant wife for this, his pregnant wife having scamming him. Let me call it scam because that's a big scam. So she's been buying the pregnancy, I don't know, pregnancy care medicine pregnant women take while they are pregnant, like vitamins. She's been buying it. She's been taking 45,000 naira from him to buy that drug. And actually, the original price is 14,500. So 14,500 is the original price, but she's been collecting 45,000 from her husband to buy that drug. Now he decides to go buy it on his own. Innocently, he went to get the drug and he found out that it's 14,500. And he's coming to ask her, like, how much do you say? How much do you buy this drug? How much do you take from me to buy this drug? And she's playing dumb. She's like, what do you mean? I still have. Why did you go and buy? I don't know what you're talking about. Like, why did you go and buy another one? Playing dumb, like she could not understand why he was asking that question. Now, women will play dumb to manipulate you. That's one thing for sure. They will play dumb. They will act like they don't know what you're saying. They will act like you're not making sense. Like, what do you even mean? I don't even understand. Are you even speaking English? Like, what are you saying? You're confusing me. Please let it slide. That's the way they're trying to manipulate you. Okay, that's a huge manipulation that women do. So do not fall for it. If your woman does something sketchy and you call her out on it, make sure that she's accountable for it. Make sure that she understands the offense. All right, make sure she understands it because women like to play dumb, like they don't know what they're like. They don't know what you're saying. They are automatically they are confused. They don't know what's happening. Da, 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 da. Don't fall for it because that woman played dumb. She, oh my God, she really played like she had no idea what he was talking about. It's just, I even in the comment section, some women were saying, oh, babes, just tell him that he got the fake one, or maybe he got it from the wrong pharmacy, or maybe they've been overcharging you. You see, they will play dumb like they don't know what you're talking about. So make sure that if your woman is behaving this way, that you call her out on this bullshit and tell her that you will not tolerate this, because just imagine how far they can actually take it. Okay, so do not tolerate this from women. They are manipulating you and trying to get control over you. And the next on my list is sudden crisis, and I this is the next because it still, links to the story I was talking about. So while this man confronted her, and well, I don't know if I can add a video to this, so if I can add it, I will put it here, but I don't want to have any copyright, infringement, so maybe I will not add it to this video. But anyways, while he was calling her out and saying, how much did you buy this, and she was playing dumb, like, I don't know what you're saying, like, why did you go and get another one? I told you I still have, like, why are you asking me that question? Don't you know how much they sell it? All of those things. All of a sudden, she started saying, oh, I don't even know what's wrong with my ear. Oh, please stop, stop, stop. I don't know what's even wrong with my ear. Like, something is paining me. All of a sudden, there is sudden crisis. So women will use sudden crisis to remove your mind from the matter on ground. to address the elephant in the room. They might just start saying, you know, I've been feeling so much pain in my belly. Oh, baby, stop screaming. I have severe headache now. What's your problem? Later, we'll talk about it. I'm actually in so much pain. All of a sudden, they will have a crisis that you cannot understand or explain where it's coming from. So yes, this is a way women use to manipulate you, okay? They use it to manipulate you when they've done something fishy or they're trying to do something crazy. So do not fall for it. If your woman did something wrong, call her out on it and do not believe when all of a sudden she has a problem. Okay, another biggest way they manipulate you is to withhold affection. Yes, now a lot of women are you know, a lot of women are culprits of this, me in particular. Okay, I've done this a million times. Okay, and it's actually not very good, because yes, we use it to manipulate men, we use it to get what we want from men. So we will withhold our affection, you know, the whole silent treatment, won't talk to you, won't chat with you. You know, I even used to do this to my mom. That's the honest truth. I used to do this a lot to my mom. I will withhold affection because I know, like, I've always been her, like, her chit chat buddy. So like, each time she pisses me off or I ask for something and she doesn't want to give it to me, I'm like, you know, very cold towards her. You know, while we're watching a movie together, I will not contribute. I'll be on my phone, and I'm someone who likes to talk and, you know, make her laugh, you know, do funny faces, dance, and, you know, all of this craziness. But I will withhold all of this affection that, you know, brings light and, you know, happiness to her, until, you know, she's like, okay, sorry, or what's that, okay, take this and fix whatever you want to fix. So yes, women do it a lot. Okay, we will withhold affection, withhold sex, no cuddling, even that sweet food you like, we will not cook it, we will not give you attention, we'll not gist with you, all of those things. So if your woman is constantly doing this, constantly, okay, just not having understanding, because there should be an understanding. Okay, there's a time a woman can just be petty and be like a baby for you to give her something or do something for her. But when you find out that it's always like, you must, and she doesn't have that understanding to understand that the reason why I'm not doing this is not because I don't love you, it's because this and this, and she doesn't care, like, the whole world can burn down, you just have to do it, and she doesn't care. So she doesn't have the understanding that she's very manipulative and just trying to control you and make your life miserable. Okay, so make sure that you understand when she's just being petty and being girly, than when she's just being, and when she's just being controlling and being manipulative. So when she withholds affection and gives you that silent treatment, she's trying to manipulate you. This is a very dark tactics, and you need to always pay attention to this. And this is the end of the video for today. Let me know if you enjoyed this video, and if you enjoyed it, make sure you like and share so other people can watch it. And guys, make sure you go support me on my website. I have some ebooks. I really want you to support me, like, so that I can be encouraged to make more ebooks on that website. Okay, so until next time, like, share, and subscribe, and bye for now. Mwah.